Hello, and welcome to Lux News. Today in the news, today on stream, I should say, we will be doing a Microsoft Azure sponsored segment where we will go over learning about creating bots. We'll go over the bots again, and we will learn to deploy them onto a website so that you can have your bot live on your very own site. That's it for Lux News. Have a great day. So, we are now going to pause on the game development. We're going to be creating bots. So we did this before, but we didn't put them onto a website yet. So this is going to be the full way through. So we're going to be using Microsoft Azure. This is a sponsored segment from Microsoft. Thank you very much. You guys haven't heard of this. It's like a Q&A bot, right? So we go to qnamaker.ai. You go through and we're gonna set a few things up. So let's open up the Azure portal too. If you guys are wanting to do this, Azure it's a free subscription. And when you first sign up, they actually give you something like over $200 in credit to play around with. So that's pretty cool. I definitely think it's worth checking it out and learning how this stuff works. Here is what the portal looks like when you log in. Okay, the first thing we need to do is create a new resource group, a resource group. We want to make a web app bot. You know what? It will tell us what we need in a second here. Boy hacks, welcome. QnA Maker, we're on this. Oh, it's because I'm not signed in, isn't it? Let me sign in. That's what we need to make, a knowledge base. That was the word I'm looking for. So, when you sign in, you now have access to create a knowledge base. So we need to go into Azure and create a QnA service. That's where it will show us where to go. Yeah, first, don't quote me on the exact amount, because I don't know what it is, Canadian versus US, but it was like over $200, I think. So we're going to need a resource group. That's what we don't have. Resource group, we'll create over here. Here it is, resource group. You guys have any suggestions, recommendations on what kind of theme of a bot we want to make? Maybe we want to turn ourselves into bots. I think that would be the funnest thing. Imagine going to a website and people can talk to you, and you can put in all your answers how you would normally answer the questions. I'm gonna make myself. You guys, if you're following along, you can make yourselves. Lana bot resource group. Let's do that. Oh, wait a second. I put that in the wrong place. Here it is. Pay as you go. Call it Lana bot resource group. Region, I'm in Canada. Central Canada, I think kind of central, kind of like Eastern Central. That works there. So review and create. And we have reviewed it. Now we can create it. And it's already done. That was quick and easy. Now let's go back here and go to create a Q&A service. Does it show up yet? Yes, it does. Cool. So we'll call it LanaBot. What are we making again? Q&A service. Q&A. We'll go for the... the free one. Lana bot Q&As. And we'll go with this. So there's different pricing tiers on this, on the search. This is going to be the URL for it. I'm going to just call it Lana bot. I wonder if that'll be available. No, it's not. I'll call it... what about Lux? Luxbot's probably almost definitely taken. Oh, it's not! Okay, good. I don't think we need insights right now. So we'll create that. And then we can come back here and now we can create the knowledge base. So I have my login. We need to refresh this. It might take a second to show up. So here it is here. Let's refresh. My login. That thing. There it is. Name your knowledge base, Luxbot KB. And here is pretty cool. You could add it from like an FAQ on a website or doc or a PDF just by like filling in the thing here or a file name. That way you can have all your stuff done ahead of time. It's pretty cool. But you can also do it once you've created the knowledge base and then you can have some of the default stuff taken care of through their, what do they call it? Chit chat. Through chit-chat. Add chit-chat to your knowledge base by choosing from one of our 5 pre-built personalities. Professional, friendly, witty, caring, and enthusiastic. Which one do we want our bot to be, guys? Which one shall we pick today? I can assure you it works with Unity. We picked Witty last time. Let's be caring today, you know? Let's have a really kind bot. And then we create it. Oh, this happened to me before. It takes a second for it to recognize some of the things that we've set up. So I might need to give it a minute. Let's go through again. Lux. There it is. Now it's recognizing it. While that's going, I'm gonna log into my internet hosting. It can be the bot that wants to be everyone's friends. This is a weird question. If you guys had to make yourself into a bot, which of those would you pick to describe your personality? I feel like enthusiastic might actually be me. I'm a little bit too enthusiastic. So enthusiastic. Okay, so I'm signing into my hosting. So I'll keep that ready. I have Linalux.games. It's like bare basic website right now, but we're gonna put Linalux.games/bot or something like that for this test. So I'll keep my file manager ready. So when we created that knowledge base, it generates all this stuff from the default personality type we gave it. If someone says anything like these questions, it will give you this answer. Ask me anything, ask me a question. It's like, I can't think of anything to ask. I think what we can do here is add like multiple ways to respond to it. Follow-up prompts can be used to guide the user through a conversational flow. Prompts are used to link Q&A pairs and can be displayed as buttons or suggested actions in a bot. For example, you can have these links show up in your answer, which is pretty cool. I actually used one the other day and it set me up with like a meeting with someone. It doesn't need to be that way. This could just guide people to the right place. For this one, it was like, ask me something, tell me something. We'll say, the default is I can't think of anything to ask. We could say, I know everything about you already. That's not creepy. Our bot's gonna be super creepy. Cannot be empty. Oh, wait. We'll do the same in both. Oh, this is the question. Okay. Tell me something. Or ask me a question. Save and train. I think my bot personality would be different, like different from your own personality. My bot personality just hate everyone. Oh. So now we can test this. Are we the same age? It says, I am a bot, so I don't have an age. Now let's see if this one went in. I want to make sure that that worked right. Ask me a question. I know everything about you already. Oh, we should make creepy bot. And like it just shows up on a website. People are like, hi, I'm trying to find my way around. And CreepyBot's like, you already have it within you. You know exactly where to go. Okay, so it's already got all that stuff working. Once you're done adding in all the things you could possibly answer with. You know what I haven't done yet? We could try, actually. Is adding, like, ask me a question. Let's do a new one. Add a new Q&A pair. Let's do something like, can you help me look something up? And then the answer is like, I want to add the prompt. So display text link to Q&A. Display text. Oh, here it is. Create new. Oh, it's already adding existing ones. I see. Bacteria, welcome. Question. Let me look at the Q&A pairs again. Multi-turn conversation with chatbot. Oh, here's enable multi-turn interaction URLs. Cool. So here it is in here. So to link to an existing question answer pair as a follow-up prompt. Oh, so you have to create a question and answer pair. As a follow-up prompt, please select the row for the question answer pair. A bot that talks cryptically would be funny. Can you make a bot to troll your own chat? What would be the best Twitch bot to make? I wonder how we would implement this into Twitch. That would be pretty funny. Okay, we're gonna keep going. We're gonna keep going here. I wanna like do create new. What is this gonna give me? I don't know. I'd have to do more reading on it, I think. Let's stick to what we've got. Regular answers. Oh, let's put a URL in though. Answer. VacVacPixel, welcome. Okay, let's save and train. Now the next step is, after it's trained, okay, publish. While that's working, let's make a website. Let's just have the text, welcome to the all-knowing Luxbot. Welcome to the bot? That doesn't really make sense. Welcome to the home of. To the. Home of the Bramville, welcome. And we'll go like, I'm out here at 3. Please ask your questions below. So let's make this our index. And let's upload that to make sure we have that working. We'll replace it once we put the bot into it. So I've uploaded that to my lanalux.games. I put it in the directory bot. So now when you go to that, here's what we have. Next step, you know what's bothering me that it's not centered though. I'll just put it in a div and make sure I center the div. Boop, boop. I'm gonna put my CSS directly in here for this, just because we're just testing this stuff out. Style, type. Div text center. I'd have to upload that again, but we're gonna upload again when you have the bot in. Here's our website. Here's our bot has been deployed. What's next? Well, I'll tell you what's next. Create the bot. So far so good. Let's stick to that one. QnA Aki, I didn't have to put that in before. That's interesting. Let's create it, see if it will put it in for me. What? What? Oh, it's because it's over here, isn't it? Key? Okay, we didn't make one yet. We gotta create it. Oh, key. Key used to authorize requests to your bot, your Q&A knowledge base. I wonder if it's that's here. Well, we have my knowledge bases. I have this one. Where's the key for it? Settings. Endpoint key. Would this be what we want? Let's try that. Yes, that's what we needed. Excellent. Okay. Now, I want to see my bots. Where's my bots? Here's my bot. Here we go. Channels. So we click on our bot, click on channels, and now we can get bot embed codes. Choose a channel to get embed code for, copy and paste your website. Has moved. Okay, let's go here. We're going to get this embed code, and we're going to put it into our HTML right here. Do a line break. We need to put our secret code. We'll put that in. And we'll save it. And then let's upload it again into our file manager and our hosting. So I'm gonna do that over here. I'm just gonna remove the one I have. Actually, I think I can just upload it and that will overwrite it. So select file, that will be the index. Yes, overwrite it. And now if we go to lanalux.games/bot. I think we have it. Hello? Oh, it says hi. Are you Luxbot? Uh-oh. No Q&A maker answers were found. Okay, we need to add one then. Let's go to our bot. Our knowledge base. And I think that now once we add a Q&A pair, are you Luxbot? Of course I am. So save and train. And then publish. Oh, hey, Rina. How you doing? We're making bots. It's very fun. Welcome to the home of the all-knowing Luxbot. Now we can say, are you Luxbot? Of course I am! And it answers. Oh, I can't wait to completely automate myself. This is going to be so nice. Every time somebody wants to talk to me, I'll be like, just go to this URL. It's all the information you need is right there. And that's it. And that's how you get a bot to take over your life for you. Now I can focus on other things instead of answering questions. Does anybody in chat have questions on automating yourself, turning yourself into a bot? I have an issue with my computer. Yeah, go talk to my bot real quick. Is it going to be like Terminator? We can only hope so, sweaty. How do you do a thing? Well, let's ask the bot. How do you do a thing? I can do stuff like chat with you or answer questions. Oh, Luxbot. You're so helpful. Yeah, everyone, please redirect all your questions to Luxbot from now on. Thank you. And I think that's the end of our review of our bot making. We'll be doing it again once a month. If you guys have any requests on Azure, actually, please DM me, because I was thinking about doing like a Skype, how to deploy to Skype, but I don't really use Skype, so I don't know, maybe Facebook? I don't use Facebook either, but it might be cool to learn how to make a Facebook bot. But if there's something specific that you guys wanted to know, just send me a message. And as you guys have learned in Discord, I won't respond right away, but I will eventually respond. Maybe, if you're lucky. Rumor has it, you don't wait for it.